Hi, I'm Mesa Salida, and I'm here at Georgia Aquarium's Tropical Diver Gallery.
Home to this incredible Pacific Barrier Reef habitat. This is one of the largest living coral reefs in a North American aquarium. It's a massive marine jungle just crawling with animals like bird wrasse, yellow tangs, anthias, literally thousands of sea creatures. Now, what makes this place so magical? Some of you might say it's the fish or the coral, but I'm going to say that it's the water. So today, we're going to find out what's inside this water and what it takes to keep all these sea creatures healthy and vibrant. Let's begin our investigation here, Georgia Aquarium's Pacific Barrier Reef. It's a saltwater sanctuary filled with a whopping 164,000 gallons of water. It's designed to look and feel just like the coral reefs in the Indo-Pacific region of the ocean. Coral reefs are sensitive and stunning. They're home to about 25% of all marine life and protect our coastlines from erosion. That's why we need to protect them from threats like pollution, rising water temperatures, and overfishing. Back here at Georgia Aquarium, maintaining tropical divers' complex habitat is an important job, and keeping the water levels normal is essential for these animals to thrive.
Here in this exhibit, just like in the ocean, these coral reefs provide shelter and food for all of the creatures that live here. So if something happens to the coral, it's going to affect everything around it, big time.
Let's continue exploring and meet a coral expert here at the top of Tropical Diver.
Hi, Steve.
Hey, Mesa, how's it going?
I'm pretty good. What are you doing there?
Well, I'm just taking a closer look at our coral propagation system, and we utilize this tank almost like a farm where we grow coral to transplant into our larger coral reef habitat behind us here.
So the water in here must be very important to whether or not these things are going to thrive inside this environment.
Absolutely. These corals are very, very sensitive to a number of different water quality parameters.
Steve has to keep a constant eye on these waters, looking for three basic qualities. First, the water has to be clear enough to let sunlight through. The temperature needs to be kept at a steady 25 degrees Celsius. Finally, the water chemistry has to be in perfect balance. Steve and his team introduced a bunch of new creatures to the exhibit, like these black blotch fantail rays. The extra food they'll chow down on adds extra nutrients. That could throw the water quality off balance and possibly prevent the coral from thriving. Let's keep investigating. To find out if the habitat is healthy, we need to get wet. We're helping Steve take his daily water sample. To make sure everything's on track, we'll need to run it through some tests.
So while I take this down to the lab, I've got a job for you.
Everything about the Tropical Diver Gallery here at Georgia Aquarium is designed to keep these coral reefs healthy and thriving. So when the water chemistry changes, we've got to address it as quickly as possible. Let's head down to the water quality lab to meet my friend Susan. She'll be able to get a read on this water.
Hi, Mesa, how are you?
I'm doing well, thanks. Can you tell me a little bit about where we are and what this is?
You are in the middle of the water quality lab at Georgia Aquarium, and this is where all the water gets tested.
This water quality lab runs over 5,000 tests each week, testing for things such as pH, alkalinity, and temperature.
Nobody comes to the aquarium to see the water, and yet if the water weren't perfect, there'd be an issue. Sure.
What have you brought me here?
It's from Tropical Diver, and I'm hoping you can take a look at it and help me figure out what's going on.
Okay, let's start with a phosphate.
Susan suspects the new rays might elevate the water's phosphate levels. Lee, a lab tech, is helping us run the test.
And do we like phosphate?
Not usually.
Okay. No. Well, hopefully it's going to stop getting even more blue. So this takes a little bit of time, huh?
A little bit, and we're going to test it on our spectrophotometer.
Okay.
So we're measuring how much light is reflected or absorbed by our water sample. The darker the blue, the higher the phosphate. While we're waiting on our results, let's dive into some data and check back in a little bit. Since coral reefs make their home in the ocean, this exhibit is full of salt water. Despite its name, saltwater is mostly just plain old water, and a little over 3% dissolved salt, mostly sodium chloride. But there are also some naturally occurring ions essential to marine life, like how calcium helps corals build up their skeletons.
All right, so what did we find out here?
Well, the spectrophotometer has let us know that you have a slightly elevated phosphate, and for that I'd recommend a small water change.
Oh, that seems like good news. Not so bad.
Looks like Susan answered our question. The new rays are elevating the water's phosphate levels. All we need to do is swap out a little of the water, and Tropical Diver will be good to go.
Now that's what I call science in action. Remember to look for the science all around you, and until then, stay curious.